Hi everyone, my name is Sarah and I'm a librarian with the Public Library of Youngstown in Mahoning County. I'm going to talk to you today about learning how to crochet. I've been crocheting for 20 plus years now. My mom and grandma taught me when I was a little girl, and I have been making clothes, hats, blankets, and toys ever since. First things first, the library does offer all kinds of amazing resources for crocheters of every level, from newbies to experts. If you can't get to the library, we do offer some amazing digital resources. With your library card, you can access information and digital magazines through discoverahobby.com, the Hobbies and Crafts Reference Center, and RB Digital. These resources can be accessed through our website, www.libraryvisit.org. There are also all sorts of crochet ebooks on Overdrive and Hoopla. Again, all you need is your library card. All right, now for your tools. To learn to crochet, you really just need three things: yarn, a crochet hook, and a good pair of scissors. For your first project, keep the yarn simple. Don't worry if it's pretty or fancy. You want something easy to work with. I would suggest a worsted weight yarn or a number 4 weight. If you check the label, you'll see a symbol that looks like this that tells you the yarn weight. I would also recommend a lighter color yarn to start. Darker colors can be difficult to see initially, especially if you crochet in the evenings like I do. Your crochet hook should also be one that matches your yarn. Again, the label will tell you what size hook to use with the yarn you're getting. Today I'm going to be using an H hook. Before we get started though, I do have some tips. First and most important, do not stress out, please. You are learning and you are going to mess up, and that is okay. I still mess up, but this is all for practice. Also, don't have a plan on making something. The important thing now is not that you make something, but that you learn. Get the motions down. Finally, have fun. Even when I mess up, this is still a hobby that relaxes me. The first stitch you will need to know is called the chain, and it is the foundation of every crochet project and is the easiest one to learn.
And we're going to get started on learning how to crochet, but the first thing you need to do is learn how to chain. So we're going to take our yarn, and you're going to start by making a simple slip knot. What I like to do is just hold the end with my pinky and thumb, wrap around, and then pull a loop through there. And it looks pretty big, but it does allow you to adjust the loop. So you can just slide it onto your crochet hook, hold that tail, and tighten the knot. You do want it to be a little bit tight, but not tight enough that it's stuck. You need it to be able to slide easily along your hook. All right, so to chain, it's very simple. You take your yarn, wrap from the back of the hook to the front, and then just slide it through. So back to front, and slide it through. And you'll see you'll end up with some nice little V's right here. That's all you want. Okay, just make sure everything's nice and loose. You don't want to pull too tightly. There's my cat who comes to say hi every time I have yarn. So back to front and pull through. And you'll just keep doing that until you have your chains as long as you want. If your hook slides off like mine just did, just pull the loop up a little bit, slide the hook back through, and get it nice and tight but a little bit loose again, and keep going. All right, now you've got chaining down, and we will next work on the single crochet. And we finished our chains, so now we're ready to turn and work on single crochet. Now, one thing to remember is that when you've done your chains, however many you're going to make, to turn to start your single crochets, you need to add one more. So I just did 10 single crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So now I'm going to add one more, because when we do our single crochet, we're not going to go into that stitch. We're going to skip this one and work right here in this next one. You can see the V right there, and you're just going to put your hook in between. I usually use my fingernail. Okay, so you have two loops on your hook now. And again, you're going to wrap back to front, pull through just the first loop. Then you're going to wrap back to front again and pull through both loops. Again, you can just pull through if your hook falls off. Okay, and you're going to do the same thing in the next one. I usually cover up the chains that I'm not going to be working on. So you just kind of split the V right there, put your hook through, back to front, pull through once, wrap back to front, and pull through twice. You can see you get those nice little V's that we'll work on again when we get ready for our next row. Okay, so back, put through, back to front, back to front, pull through. And that is how you make a single crochet.
Again, and we are going to work on our double crochets now. So we have worked on our chains, our single crochets, and now we're going to do a turn for a double crochet. Now with single crochet, you would just chain one, turn around, and continue the single crochets. For a double crochet, you're actually going to chain three. So one, two, three. And then we're going to flip it so that now we're looking at the back of our work. So you don't see the V's anymore because they're in the front, but you do have these little bumps back here. Now, this chain three will usually count as your first double crochet. So this V right here, we're not going to work on that one. So the first thing we do for a double crochet is you wrap the yarn back to front around your hook. So we're not going into this first one right here. We're going to go into this next stitch. You're not going to split the V like you do when you're going through a chain. You're going to go through both of them. Okay, so then you wrap the yarn around your hook again, then pull that one through first. Now you should have three loops on your hook. Make sure they're a little bit loose, not too tight. They wrap around, but you can still move them. So now we wrap the yarn, pull through two loops, wrap the yarn, and pull through two loops again. And that is a double crochet. So again, we wrap, and you push through, wrap, pull through once to get three loops. Wrap, pull through two loops, wrap, and pull through two loops. And you just keep going till you get to the very end. And remember to, when you turn, you're going to chain three for a double crochet. So that's it. You've chained, you've single crocheted, and now you've double crocheted. And that's enough to get you started for crocheting. Have a great day, everyone.